Hello there, and it is another brand new week, and welcome to another brand new episode of our weekly devotion with yours truly. Woo-hoo. Well, I want to encourage you this week with a story that's found in 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 7. During that time, Israel was divided into two kingdoms. The northern kingdom is known as Israel, and the southern kingdom is known as Judah. The capital city for Israel is Samaria, and the Bible tells us during that time there was a great famine. The people were desperate, there were no food, and the enemy, the king of Aram, then took advantage of the plight of the people of Israel and mobilized his entire army, right? And marched up and laid siege to Samaria. So they blocked people from supplies from going into the city, and they blocked people from coming out, thinking that, hey, they will be so desperate, they will be so hungry, they eventually will surrender themselves. And the people obviously inside the city were desperate. Well, in chapter 7, they tell us that they were actually four lepers. They were camped outside the city. At that time, leprosy is seen as incurable. It is also seen as very, very contagious. And so they are not allowed to mingle with the public or their family. And so they have to stay outside of the city. And so they were caught between the devil and the deep blue sea here. So they were basically in no man's land. And then they said to themselves, if we enter into the city, the famine is in there, and we will die because there's no food. But if we sit here, we die also. And one of them said, therefore, come, let us fall into the host of the Syrians. If they save us alive, we shall live. If they kill us, then we shall die. You know, either way, we will die. But we have possibly better chance here because there are food here. And so they decided to walk towards the camp of the Syrian army. As these four men make their way towards the Syrian camp, unbeknownst to them, God went ahead of them. This Syrian army began to hear loud rumbling noises of chariots and horses that were coming towards them. It gets louder and louder, and these soldiers thought that the king of Israel has recruited other militaries to assist them in fighting the Syrian army. And so they were so frightened, and they scrambled and they disappeared. They left the camp. And this poor man walked into the camp not knowing what happened, and they found that it was empty. There were food abound, you know, and treasures and clothing, and they then enjoyed themselves and add to their heart, to their hearts. Content. You know what? Some people say God show up. Well, I don't believe that. You know, in my theology, God don't show up. You know, God did not show up. Why? Because God never left in the first place. When God says, I am for you and with you, I will never forsake you or abandon you. So if God never left, why? You know, that means he doesn't have to show up. He is always there for you, and he is there with you. You know, there's always war in the heavenlies, and you know that God is there. And I know that when I was teaching in a course where there were about 300 students in the lecture theater, and after my lecture, one of my students came forward and told me that, sir, I am feeling very unwell, I'm nauseating, and I need to be excused from this class, and I want to go home. I said, hey, sure, please go home and see a doctor. And she went home, and before she actually left, she turned around and said, sir, tomorrow I need to talk to you, I will call you tomorrow. I said, sure, go home and rest. And true enough, the next day she called me and she said, I was a student that was ill yesterday. If you remember me, I said, yeah, I remember you. And how are you? She said, I'm still nauseating, I'm still feeling dizzy. I said, what did the doctor say? Well, the doctor did not find anything wrong with me. I suppose, she said, it was because of your lecture. I was like, what? My lecture? I wasn't even teaching from the Bible. I think I was teaching about the psychology of adolescence, you know, and the mindset of the young teenagers. And she said, it was your lecture. I said, what about my lecture? She said, during your lecture in the lecture theater, there is this force that is so powerful, and it was helping you to lecture. Wow. Wow. Even as I was lecturing, there was war in the heavens. She said that she is very sensitive to all this spiritual thing. in the environment, and she could feel that there is this force that's helping me in the podium to teach. And then she asked me, "Are you a Christian?" I said, "Yes, I am." I said, "Oh, no wonder, must be of God." And then I prayed for her. You know what? If wherever you go, God never leave you. And if God never leave you, He don't have to show up. He was already there, just like He was there for these four men. I just know what's going on in your life. You may be going through some challenges. Your plight plus His presence equals His providence. And so, you know, the people, the four men were able to enjoy the feasting because God provided for them and God was with them. And when your plight combined with God's presence equals providence, it also gives you power and it also gives you peace. So whatever that you're going through today, hey, don't focus on your problem, your situation, your environment, those who may have betrayed you and all that. Focus on His presence because He is always there for you. He did not show up. He was already there all the time. Okay, so may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. Okay, in the course of this week, remember, open your eyes and see the presence of God and not the presence of your enemy. God never show up because He was already there for you and with you. And have a great week ahead. God bless. Ciao.